Hi friends, this is Anirban. Welcome to my Geeky Anirban channel. Today I will discuss something about the processors which are used in the smartphones. So, especially there are four types of processors we are using: Qualcomm Snapdragon, MediaTek, Exynos, and the iOS devices, that is A chipset or A10 chipset, A11 chipsets that are used in iPhone. So Exynos are using only on the Samsung smartphones, and rest of two are using on all the smartphones, Snapdragon and MediaTek. The Snapdragon is powered by Qualcomm, whereas the MediaTek has itself a processor, where it is a semiconductor company made in Taiwan, and Snapdragon is an American based company. It is it has a high quality performance and a high efficient processor, whereas the MediaTek as a low efficient processor and the low budget quality. So Snapdragon processors are more powerful than MediaTek. Why? I'm telling this. So here they include a variety of processors that are dual core, quad core, hexa core, octa core, and deca core. MediaTek are also providing this. The difference thing is that the Qualcomm Snapdragon used the ARM Cortex chipset, and the MediaTek are also using the ARM Cortex chipset. The ARM doesn't have their own processor. They used to give the license to the MediaTek and the Qualcomm processor, and the MediaTek used to directly take that processor and they are manufacturing that. Whereas the Snapdragon takes the ARM Cortex processor, and with that they are tweaking with that processor and optimizing, and that's why the Snapdragon are providing the best processor in all the smartphone brands. Now the smartphones are dividing into two processors, that are MediaTek and Qualcomm. So in a budget category, the MediaTek are providing the low segment processors, whereas the Qualcomm are also providing the budget type of processor in the budget phones. The difference is that the Qualcomm Snapdragon 425 and 430 are a budget type of processor, and the MediaTek 6757 and the 6753 or 6737 are also a budget type of processor. Difference is that Snapdragon 425 or 430 has a price around means this type of phones, means those phones which are having the 430 or a 435 processor or a 425 processor, most probably about 7,000 to 10,000. Within that budget, MediaTek are also providing 6757 or a 6737 processor with that particular budget. And the functionality or the specification are huge different, because they have a heating issues, they have a lagging issues, or they have a gaming issues. Because when you play a game on that type of budget processor, it lags, whereas the Qualcomm Snapdragon it optimizing a huge type of gaming efficiency processor. So in this way the Qualcomm are much ahead than MediaTek, and Qualcomm is a very old company. It has a high market share than a MediaTek. I'm not telling the MediaTek are very bad, but according to that the Qualcomm are the best among these budgets, because Qualcomm Snapdragon are providing the flagship phones, whereas the MediaTek are also providing the flagship phones, but that are not up to the mark comparing to the Qualcomm Snapdragon. So before buying a smartphone, many users are thinking, what type of processor should I buy? Because the maximum person don't know about the processors. They used to go a shop, they used to see a camera quality or any other things, but not think about the processors. Especially the Xiaomi, Vivo, Oppo, Lenovo are providing a such type of MediaTek processor, which should not be used in that price segment, because many customers don't know what processors they are giving. Snapdragon is one of the finest and smoothest processor among all these. So before going to a shop for a smartphone to buy, please think about the processors and think what type of frequency they are giving, what type of Adreno they are giving. GPU means the Snapdragon are providing the GPU of Adreno, whereas the MediaTek are providing the ARM Cortex Mali GPU, which are most low efficient processor. Therefore the battery consumption are much higher. It takes the battery very much. Whereas the Adreno GPU are providing much low efficient battery life. So that's a different, because MediaTek are using others processors and Qualcomm are using the Qualcomm Snapdragon are also using the others processors, for example ARM Cortex. With that, they are tweaking, they are optimizing in that processor. Therefore, the Snapdragon has a huge capacity for battery efficient processor, for battery efficient, high gaming performance, and without any lagging free. So these are all things about the Qualcomm Snapdragon and a MediaTek. So if you think that it helps you, please don't forget to like or don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.